book of essays that contributed to the debate about Trump's mental stability. And she has issued a further report recently that you might have seen in a Now This News video clip about Donald Trump's mental capacities as evidenced by his actions in the Mueller report. She has fascinating things to say, not only about Trump's own derangement and incapacity, but of cultural derangements and incapacities and dementia, the kind of things that you see in people who believe in QAnon, Pizzagate, anti-vax, and other conspiracy theories. Dr. Lee, welcome to TrumpCast.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
So I was very struck when your book about Trump's mental capacities came out, and glad that you're keeping the urgent issue of our incapacitated president in the news with this new video you and your team put together after the Mueller report came out, after you read the Mueller report.
Yes, the report was particularly poignant in terms of providing us with exactly the kind of information we would have sought to do a mental capacity evaluation. We couldn't resist. In fact, the report was begging for such an evaluation. We were fortunate to have a document of such abundant, high-quality information. Under sworn testimony, we hardly ever get this kind of an opportunity when doing ordinary mental capacity exams. So it was an especially good opportunity.
First, I love to hear the Mueller report praised, and especially praised for this, you know, other use that it has. Even if professionals so far couldn't make a decision about obstruction and tell the bar, there may be other ways to read it in other professions and for other purposes, and you've really shown that.
In fact,
Chloe did good. Eleven days from now, Margaux said I'm gone. So I suspect within the next several days, we've